Good afternoon, Robert Scribbler filming south and east from Jeanette's Pier at some 1 to 2 foot waves. Rolling in off the North Atlantic Ocean. Did get out into the water with the Dominator 2 I just picked up from the Outer Banks Boarding Company today. 10 liters less than my Lost Rocket Redux. And got out for the first 15 minutes. Was barely able to catch two waves, but then suddenly there was like a little switch that turned on and I figured out how to use that thing and picked up 6 more rides in this pretty challenging, mostly blown out, but occasional 1 to 2 foot waves coming in surf here near Jeanette's Pier in this section. It is high tide and I'm looking down from the pier at a pretty high angle, so the waves do look smaller than they actually are, but nonetheless, challenging conditions on a small board, and managed to catch some good waves, and I'm excited to challenge myself and learn more on the Firewire Dominator 2, which is turning out to be pretty fun. I did try it in the tri-fin configuration today. I'm gonna switch up to the quad tomorrow. Hopefully there'll be some waves tomorrow to ride with it. All right, so let's get down to some of the local wave observations. Although I do want to give a shout out to Noah Schneider, who did drop off that new board out at the Outer Banks Boarding Company, and Outer Banks Boarding Company who gave me a great deal on my new board. So shout out to Noah, who is a well-known pro surfer and artist here. Thanks for the new board, dude. All right, so let's get down to the local observations here in the Outer Banks, provided by buoys, model data, and the wave monitors. And right here at Nag's Head, according to the official buoy data, it says 2 foot plus. I'm gonna say it's 1 to 2 myself. I don't think this is 2 foot plus. This is rather a bit smaller than the official data coming in my opinion. Primary swell out of the southeast at 2.5 foot and 8 seconds. I think it's angling in more to the north now with those northwest winds, and swell's starting to get a bit blown out with those strong west-northwest winds at around 25 miles per hour. Very strong winds coming out of the west-northwest here. We've got cooler air temperatures with a front coming through at 62 degrees right now. Ocean water temperature is holding in at 68. High tide today about now, 12:45. And low tide this evening at 7:39. Down south in Rodanthe, we got 2 foot waves, fairly clean conditions. East-southeast swell at 2 foot and 8 seconds. Winds out of the west, very strong, 26 miles per hour. Air temperatures 61 degrees. Ocean water temperatures 68. High tide today 1:32 in the afternoon, and a low tide this evening at 8:21. Hopping up to the north in Virginia Beach, we've got 1 to 2 foot waves and fairly clean conditions. And then jumping back to the south at Buxton, we've got 2 foot waves, semi-clean conditions. Southeast swell at 2.1 foot and 8 seconds. West-northwest winds at 30. Sounds like blown out conditions to me, but who knows, maybe there's a few hollow rides, barrels. It is Buxton after all. If there's a swell in the Atlantic Ocean, it's gonna hit Buxton. Air temperature 61 degrees Fahrenheit. Ocean water temperatures 72 degrees. High tide today at 12:57 p.m. Low tide today 7:39. And yeah, as I film, looking kind of more and more blown out. I think the conditions were better when I got here earlier. Although it does look like the swell is trying to firm up here in this little gravel section that I was in earlier. I'm kind of filming it to give you guys a little bit of an idea where the waves might be here near Jeanette's Pier, although there's also a little sandbar. I didn't check that out today, but that's actually a pretty good section down to the south. Last of all at Frisco, 3 foot plus waves and choppy conditions. Right now, so there's a residual swell coming in from the southeast. We've got winds coming in from the west and northwest. Over the next couple of days, this is going to turn the swell to the north. And the swell is likely going to build as the winds turn toward the north. And as that happens, we are likely to see choppier conditions as well. So we'll just have to see. There might be periods of chop and clean conditions, as tends to happen here in the fall and the winter time. We're just going to have to be alert to conditions as they present themselves. All right, let's talk about the weather. Weather observations provided by the National Weather Service and the National Hurricane Center and the Global Forecast System model. All right, we have a low pressure system off New Jersey right now that's bringing strong west and northwest winds over the Outer Banks, cooler temperatures. We talked about the diminishing southeast swell and the swell shifting toward the north over time with those west-northwest winds and shifting to the north. By Monday, we expect larger waves as that low pressure system provides a stronger swell. Some locations will still see clean conditions. It just depends. We're just going to have to look. Some locations will see choppy conditions. So very touch and go when it comes to wave conditions with those strong winds. Atlantic overall pretty stormy with cold core lows in the temperate zone of the Atlantic and the northern zone of the Atlantic. And we got tropical cyclones in the southern zone of the Atlantic. Mainly what we're monitoring right now with the National Hurricane Center is hurricane. I was about to say tropical storm, but it's Hurricane Tammy at 80 mile per hour winds, heading toward the northwest. Hurricane Tammy moving through the Leeward Islands today, raking the Leeward Islands with those 80 mile per hour winds as it turns more toward the north and toward Bermuda. Tammy is expected to turn toward the east of Bermuda. We're just going to have to see how far to the north Tammy gets. The further north Tammy gets, the more likely Tammy will be to influence the wave conditions here in the Outer Banks. And it would be nice to get a tropical storm slash hurricane swell. We'll just have to see what happens. All right, and last of all, we have another disturbance being monitored by the National Hurricane Center in the Caribbean Sea near Central America. This system has a 20% chance of developing into a tropical cyclone over the next 7 days. All right, so thank you for joining me for this Saturday, October the 21st session of the OVX Wave Report as we look at some relatively small and not great waves here at Jeanette's Pier. Nonetheless, there are still waves to be ridden, as I found myself today with the Dominator. Surprising that I was able to catch 8 waves on a 30 liter board in these challenging conditions. So there are waves to be had, guys. Not amazing waves, but nonetheless, there are waves. All right, so thank you for joining me for this session of the OVX Wave Report. I'm going to ask you guys to please do everything you can to help protect our coastlines from the impacts of climate change driven by fossil fuel burning and the high carbon related materials that are related to fossil fuel extraction. The primary action to combat climate change being the mass deployment of clean energy being wind, water, solar, and electric vehicles. Those are the mass deployable forms of clean energy at present, as well as all of the sustainability measures. And one of the sustainability measures that we can work on is turning our materials production into zero carbon materials production. And we're going to talk about that a little bit more on another session of the OVX Wave Report. So thank you for joining me once again, and I will be back with you guys shortly.